Hi, good morning, how are you all doing today? Well, I'm just going to set off from here from Machynlleth. I've been here for 6 nights and it's been good. You know, no bother, had a nice time here. So I'm going to head off towards Llandrindod Wells, in that area anyway. So, and I'll get back to you all later. So see you soon. Take care. Bye. Right, that's me. I'm just going to head off now. Been in the co-op, got a couple of bits and pieces, just some more milk and a bit more food. So that should keep me going for the next few days. Okie dokie. So I'll see you later wherever I am. Okay, see you later. Bye bye. Bye. I'll just put excuse me, I'll just pull in this little lay-by for a little while. It's quite a long slog up sort of windy roads, up coming all uphill, and of course I had a lot of traffic behind me, so I thought I'll pull in here, let them all get past. Obviously a lot of them going to work and stuff like that, so. And I'm gonna do myself a brew and make myself a sandwich, and then I'll talk to you all later. See you, bye. Gonna do a couple of sausage rolls. I think about 10 minutes just to warm up. I'm just adding the little book I keep. I just add me food and fuel. So just what I spent this morning in the co-op. Sounds like the kettle's going. Just having a plum. Check on these sausage rolls. Just flip them over to the other side. Oh, I think they're cooked. Have you see a ridge monkey, but they come in two halves, and then you just join them like that. And acts like a seals the heat in. You can see it's completely sealed, so it's brilliant. They're a brilliant bit of kit. I've got the extra large one as well. That's good for doing. You can do a lot more in the extra large. I'll show you that once again. That's the XL, and that's the XXL. This one. So basically it's a lot deeper, so you can get more in it. Take that finish as well, like grease proof, so you can get a lot more in it. And the two halves, they come apart as well, the handles detach as well, so it all comes off. But brilliant. You can do your chops, you can do potatoes, stir fries, you can do anything in them, and it's all non-stick. Excellent bit of kit, the XXL. Yeah, you can get them on Amazon or eBay. Just search Ridge Monkey. Well, I'm gonna have a bit of barbecue sauce. Can't beat a bit of barbecue. I was doing it again, I was talking away, and I wasn't recording. I'm losing the plot, seriously. I've arrived at the lake in Llandrindod Wells, but I think the road will come down. It's a one-way road, so I'm gonna have a walkabout and just get my bearings, and I'd probably have to move the van. It seems to be I can't go straight ahead. It's no entry, but so it's like a one-way system. So I'll go and have a wander, have a look around and see where I can park. Okay, see you in a bit. Well, I'm here at the lake in Llandrindod Wells, cafe and boathouse, I believe. I think it got Nessie out there as well. Some of our Canadian geese friends has come to say hello, expecting me to feed them. There's quite a few here. Let's have a little wander around. Little car parking space just here at the back of the cafe. Couple of big fellas there. Yeah, so if I believe Llandrindod Wells is quite a Victorian town. I don't know too much about it. As I say, I've never been here before, my first time. So I would imagine if best way to find out about it is Google it and look at Wikipedia. It'll have all the history on it there. So I'm not even going to attempt to explain it to you because I don't know myself. Looks like a little hide here, so you can do some photography. And I've got my camera with me. The different species of birds up here: grey heron, mallards, Canadian goose, which we've already seen. That's quite good. Looks like the cafe's got its lights on now. See that Nessie there a little bit closer? I'll see if I can walk around the other side and get closer still. Yeah, I think it's Buth Wales. I'm not too far away from there. I think it's about 10 miles. As you can see, this road goes all the way around the lake. And I know there is parking around here, because like I said earlier, you can get it on search for signs. Some more of those huge reeds. Little information board there on the lake. I believe in the Victorian days, it was quite a busy, popular place. Walk down on this jetty. Some mallards. And I say, I do photography, so I can get my camera out and hopefully get some birds, some nice birds. It would appear the way those cars are parked, it looks like they're in the middle of the road. just alongside it, where the darker coloured tarmac is, that's where they drive through, and where those cars are parked, that's where you park. Looks like they're sitting in the middle of the road. And this bit here is the cycle path. I think the cycle path is wider than the actual road for where the cars have to drive on. There's a great big bin here, and right next to it, fish and chip paper. Unbelievable. Look at that. You think a place like this ever come along and clean it up? I expect no sooner they've cleaned it, when it's all, the litter louts come along again, chop their litter. There's another little jetty here you can go and stand on. I would imagine fishing is prohibited here. Yeah, it's a nice place. Definitely recommend, if you're ever down this way, pay it a visit. I mean, obviously it's going to be a lot busier, a lot nicer in the summer. It's all wooded area around here as well. A bit marshy down in there. I just spoke to a local and asked him if you could fish here, and he said, yeah, you're allowed to fish. I think you have to have a permit, which I would assume you could get it from the boathouse. Quite marshy and wet. It's like a little path up here. Yeah, good. I'm not gonna, well, I can go a little bit. I haven't got my boots on, but it's not too bad. Yeah, so it's good. You can, you've got all these walks up here through the woods. Yeah, got to stay here for at least a couple of days to explore the area, and obviously you don't want to come just one night and leave the next morning. You know, I like to look around, you know, the town and whatever. Feeding the wild fowl. Please remember that the birds on the lake are wild and not domesticated. Please only feed appropriate bird food and not bread or human food. I see so many people feeding birds white bread. It's really not good for them. That wind's got up just a little bit. Be a copy of Loch Ness Monster, I would imagine. Nice property up there, so I got a lovely view. There's that fellow over there. Wells Wild Camp. I think these old signs need to be either cleaned up or... There's people in that car, and it's gone up to the car. I was standing at the side of it. Right, nearly back at the van, and you see her just sat there. And so that's the entrance to the cafe just over there, where those cars are. Kiddies play area just over there as well. So if you come with the day and you got your kids with you, a little park to play in. I'm just curious to find out what these standing stones are here. That's all written in Welsh, so there's no good even trying to say what it is. Ah, God our Father, we remember with thanksgiving the saints of your church, and among them Saint Milog, who kept the faith here in Radnorshire. Now Radnorshire, I've never heard of. I've heard of most counties in Wales, but I've never heard of Radnorshire. It's a new one on me. Through the Holy Trinity, tranquility. So I don't know if, is Capel Welsh for church? Remains of a medieval church. It is believed that Saint Milog was the son of a Romano-British chieftain from Strathclyde, and that he was born in 500 AD. His brother was a fellow Celtic saint, Gildas. Legend has it that Milog and his family settled in Anglesey in 510 AD after fleeing from the Pictish Wars, that he had received an education from the monks at the Abbey of Clancarfan in the Vale of Glamorgan. In 520 AD, Milog arrived in Cornwall and became a disciple of Saint Sebi, but he left Cornwall after an ill-fated attempt by the people to raise Saint Sebi to the Cornish throne. In 530 AD, he travelled to Gwent and then moved on to Ireland and Aran Mór. Interesting. It's got all the languages there, Welsh. It's in Dutch, in French. I think it's Belgian, Irish, and English. That's what they assume what the church looked like. I mean, we're talking about 500 AD. So is that all that remains of the church, those three stones? It was a church in this area. I mean, it could have been around here. Right, let's walk on down and go into town. one's an interesting little bit of history. And it's funny because when I was up in Burghead near Lossiemouth, it was the Pictish Fort. They were archaeologists were excavating the area and trying to find artifacts from the Picts. And like I said, they're way back in 500 AD. So yeah, all connected. It just shows you, doesn't it? At the end of the day, we were all one once upon a time. Right, we'll wander down here. Seen better days, that crazy golf course, hasn't it? Could do a good clean and a lick of paint. Little skateboard park just there, the kids. Princess Anne Leisure Park, the Princess Avenue Leisure Park, opened in July 2019. It's just nice to get out and stretch my legs and have a walk around. I mean, the weather up in Machynlleth was terrible the whole week. I was there 6 nights and I think I had one day of sunshine. Like an old Victorian building. That looks like an old swimming bath. Cycle Museum, Penny Farthing. Wow. Wonder if they're the originals. Juvenile villosy bead or whatever, bone shaker in brackets. Got one for the kids at the bank. I don't think she's been there since 1870. Not going to go in, let's just see. Dogs are welcome. Right, let's have a look down here. Yeah, I like discovering unknown places, just having a wander around. Don't need to go near shops, see enough of shops. I know some people like to do that, but I do it occasionally, but it's not really my thing. Right, it's called Rock Park Trail, yeah, Tree Trail. This trail takes you on Sir Curtius route around the Rock Park and visits the old historical trees planted as part of the original Victorian landscape design. You will also see younger trees which have continued to be planted in order to carry on the tradition of the rock plant as an arboretum. The trail is about 1.5 kilometers long and suitable for most abilities. The trees are numbered to make identification easy, and there is a leaflet to accompany you on your journey available from the spa building reception desk. enjoy the walk. I'm going to turn back after this bridge because I should have brought my camera with me. I'll go through here, have a quick look, and then I'm going to head back. And then I'll come back tomorrow with my camera. Right, that's me then. Let's get back in the van. Might make a cup of tea first, and then I'll move the van to a new location around the lake. Catch you later.
I've moved the van now and I'm turning left here. It's called Grosvenor Road. You drive all the way up down the hill the other side, and then you'll see the lake on the left hand side. And then just drive around to where I'm parked up now, right next to the lake. Okay, catch you later. Don't forget to subscribe, like and share, and leave a comment. I'd love to get a comment. And I'll see you all soon in the next one. Have a good day. Bye.